dragon and so die. That strand again had a dying fall. As it was before. O spirit of love, how quick and fresh art thou!
Will you go hunt, my lord?
What, Curio?
Hark!
Why, so I do, the noblest that I have. When mine eyes did see Olivia first, methought she purged the air of pestilence. That instant I was turned into a hart. My desires like fell and cruel hounds e'er since pursued. How now, what news from her?
So please, my lord, I may not be admitted. But from her handmaid do return this answer. The element itself, till 7 years' heat, shall not behold her face in apple view.
But, like your cloister, she will veil on her mother Wednesday in her chamber. I, then, friend, also. Her brother's dead love, she will be fresh and lasting in her sad remembrance.
Oh, she that have a heart of that fine frame, to pay this debt of love but to a brother! Away before me to sweet beds of flowers. Love thoughts lie Richmond canopied with ours.
What country, friends, is this?
This is Illyria, lady.
And what should I do here in Illyria? My brother, he's in Elysium. Perchance he is not drowned. What think you, sailors?
It is perchance that you yourself are saved.
Oh, my poor brother, and so perchance may he be.
True, madam, it's a comforting chance. Assure yourself that after our ship is split, I saw your brother, most probably in peril, by himself, to a strong mast lit upon the sea, where, like Viola on the dolphin's back, I saw him from the plain to the waves, so long as I could see.
Knowest thou this country?
Aye, madam, well, for I was bred and born not 3 hours' travel from this very place.
Who governs here?
A noble duke. In nature as in name.
What's the name?
Orsino.
Orsino? I've heard my father name him. He was a bachelor then.
And so was now, for was so very late, for but a month ago I left him hence, and then plus fresh and murmur, as you know, or great ones to the last will pilot that he did to love a fair lady.
And what's she?
A virtuous maid, the daughter of the count, that died 12 months since. Then he returned the protection of his son, her brother, who shortly also died. For who, dear love, they say she hath the journey of country in sight of men.
He will admit no kind of suit. No, not the Duke's.
I prithee, and I'll pay thee bounteously. Conceal me what I am and be my aid, for such disguise as happily shall become the form of my intent. I will serve this Duke, for it may be worth thy pains, for I can sing and speak to him in many sorts of music. That will allow me to be very worth his service. What else may have to time I will commit, only shape thou thy silence to my wit.
Be you his servant, and you are mute, I shall be.
For my tongue blabs, let mine eyes not see.
I thank thee. Lead me on.
Yeah!
He is 3,000 ducats a year.
I know half of a year and all these stuff. He's a very fool and a prodigal.
Well, fine, if you'll say so. He plays the viola damn boys and speaks three or four languages word for word without book. And he has all the good gifts of nature.
He happens to be almost natural, for besides that he's a fool, he's a great quarreler.
They're scoundrels and subtractors that say so by this hand. Who are they?
They're that I, moreover. He's drunk nightly in your company.
Well, drinking house to my niece. I'll drink to her as long as there's passage in my throat and drink malaria. He's a coward that will not drink to my niece till his brains turn over the toe like a parish top. Ah, here comes strange wagon face.
Sir Toby Belch, how now, Sir Toby Belch?
Sweet Sir Andrew.
Bless you, Fair Drew.
I'm my niece's chambermaid.
Good mistress, I desire better acquaintance.
My name is Mary, sir. Pray you well, gentlemen.
Fair lady, do you think you have fools at hand?
Sir, I am not you by hand.
All night, when will I see thee so put down?
Methinks I have no more wit than an ordinary man, but I am a great eater of beef, and I believe that does harm to my wit. I'll ride home tomorrow, Sir Toby. Your niece will not be seen. Or if she be, it's 4-1 she'll none of me. The Count himself hereby woos her.
She'll none of the Count. Tut! There's life next man.
I'll stay a month longer. Shall we set about some revels?
What shall we do else? Higher!
Cesario, you are like to be much advanced. We have known you but 3 days, and already you are no stranger.
You either fear his humor or my negligence, that you call in question the continuance of his love.
Is he inconstant, sir, in his favors?
No, believe me.
I thank you. Here comes the Count.
Who saw Cesario?
On your attendance, my lord. Here.
Stand you a while, Luke. Cesario. Thou knowest no less but all. I have enclosed to thee the book of thy secret soul. Therefore, good youth, address thy gate unto her. Be not denied access. Stand at her doors, and tell them there thy fixed foot shall grow till I have audience.
Sure, my noble lord, if she be so abandoned to her sorrow as it is spoke, she will never admit me.
Be clamorous in the old civil bounds, rather than make unprofited return.
Well, say I do speak with her, my lord. What then?
Oh, unfold the passion of my love. Surprise with this course of my dear fate, shall become thee well to act my woes.
I think that so, my lord.
Dear lad, believe it. Prosper well in this, and thou shalt live as freely as thy lord. Call his fortunes thine.
I'll do my best to woo your lady. Yet of artful strife, where I woo myself would be his wife.